Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. My name is Lonnie, and I'm glad that you joined me. My wife recently read a story about a survival situation. It involved some very experienced outdoorsmen, guy and a gal, husband and wife team, and they were way back in the backcountry. And even though they were experienced, they made a mistake. They made several mistakes, and it put them into a survival situation. So, I got to thinking about that, thinking about what I could do in the same sort of situation. So let's kind of set up a reenactment. Come along with me. This is going to be a winter survival shelter video. Let's get started. What's wrong? Spark plugs are tight. Wonder if it's fuel. I know I checked that before I left. Yep, out of fuel. Now, how did that happen? Now, let's see. Better take some time here to think. Okay. Well, there's no use blaming. No use trying to figure out what happened here. I'm out of fuel. I didn't bring any extra. I'm 30 miles back in. Broke fresh trail all the way in here. Okay. I do have my snowshoes. It's clear I'm gonna have to walk out of here. But I think it's just best if I wait until in the morning. The snow is going to be soft since I broke trail coming in here. It's going to be a real soft trail. I'm going to be sinking in. If I wait until morning, the trail will set up. It'll be a lot firmer. So, nobody knows which trail I took. And they're not expecting me back here for several days. Back to camp. So, my wife, she won't know where to look. So it's clear I'm going to have to walk out of here. I'll start in the morning. But in the meantime, I'm going to have to figure out some sort of a shelter. Okay. Well, I might as well get started. Oh. good thing I always carry this avalanche shovel with me, along with my rope come along to self-rescue when I get stuck. It's come in handy quite a few times. Okay. This is what I'm looking for. Now, whether or not this is going to work, I don't really know yet. I'll have to go up and check it out and see what it looks like. That blowdown, that root ball. Let's go check it out. For this area, that's a pretty massive root ball. Looks like it just might work. Yeah, I think that looks pretty good. All right, I better get started. What I need to do here is I need to start shoveling out a hole here where I'm gonna make my camp. The snow that's on the surface that is melted and fallen off of this, it's kind of compacted, so I'm using this to my advantage in building my wall height up. Like that. Get those walls built up a little higher. Okay, I got these walls. Got the walls outlined here. Now I just gotta start shoveling out the middle here. Thinking, yeah, but who carries a shovel with them? And who happens to have an avalanche shovel with them when they're in the backwoods? Well, if you're a backwoods snow machine traveler, an experienced one, you probably carry an avalanche shovel with you. But if you don't, most likely you do have snowshoes with you. Snowshoes, they also work as a pretty good shovel. So, if you don't have something, think, what can I use that might work?
Okay, as you can see, the shelter's all put together now. I brought in about a foot of spruce boughs here, and with me sitting on it, it squashed it down to about 6 inches. I've got about 6 inches of spruce boughs behind me, and both of those work real well. I can't feel any cold coming up through the bottom or through my back. The whole idea here, now you may be saying that this ain't no shelter. It don't have a roof. But, a shelter is something that shelters you from the elements. Okay, one of the major elements that we're fighting here in Alaska, in the backwoods of Alaska, is the cold. Okay, so the biggest asset of this type of a shelter is it blocks the wind. And you'd be surprised, the snow walls here, it reflects quite a bit of heat, retains heat in here. Once this fire gets built up to a coal bed, it'll radiate out more heat. There's three different ways that heat is transferred: convection, radiation, and conduction. The way that we're utilizing in this shelter is radiation. The heat that is radiated out from the fire is basically not affected a whole lot by a roof, because it is, it's like the warmth that you feel from the sun. That's radiation, that's radiated heat. Now, you don't need a root ball like this. Some areas don't have these. So what you could do is, if you're in an area where there's deep snow, you could make the whole shelter completely out of snow. Especially if you're in an area where there's wind-blown snow, that's ideal for blocking, using your shovel to cut out blocks and then build up blocks. So, think about the resources you have in the area you're in, and chances are there's some way, something that you could utilize to come up with the same type of thing. Oftentimes, downed logs that are laying on the ground will make an ideal reflector to utilize as a backdrop. Yeah, it's a pretty comfortable camp. Is this your best option? Maybe, maybe not. There may be better options, but this is just one more trick to put in your arsenal of knowledge. If the weather's calm, this is a pretty good shelter to build. It can be quite, I'm feeling quite a bit of warmth here. It's blocking out quite a bit of cold, and I'm experiencing quite a bit of warmth. Now, if it's pretty cold, this is, we're about 15 degrees above Fahrenheit. Now, if it's quite a bit colder than that, what you could do is you could put some crossbars across the top here, some poles, and then cover them over. You know, come out about this far maybe. Cover them over with spruce boughs, just like I did on the ground here. And that'll help hold some more heat in this area where you're gonna be. This is actually pretty nice. Keep in mind that this type of a shelter is gonna require a lot of firewood. And it's not a long-term shelter. This is something, you know, like I said, the scenario that we were describing earlier. It's a quick shelter to set up for an overnighter. Just something to get you through the night. Well, thanks for joining me, and hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you on the next video. You guys take care. If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.